Hi, my name is Fred Kohler and I'm a member of the Solidworks training team. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add assembly features to your assembly. Assembly features are unique features that are created and exist at the assembly level, but can be transferred to the part level. Let's get started. Assembly features are generally cut features added after the components have been assembled, usually affecting more than one component. The components that are affected are controlled by the feature scope. In the Feature Manager design tree, assembly features are listed below the Mates folder. The assembly feature types are found under Insert Assembly Feature or the Assembly Features dropdown on the Assembly Command Manager. They include several cut types, fillets, chamfers, holes, and some specialty types. Note that there are 5 different pattern types exclusively for assembly features. So how do we create an assembly feature? Let's add a sketch-based cut-extrude assembly feature. Like in a part file, we start with a sketch on a plane or a planar face of any component in the assembly. I'll sketch on a planar face. Unlike in a part, this triggers a warning, not an error, that you are working at the assembly level, not the part level. We can add some sketch geometry, relations, and dimensions. I'll click Assembly Features, Extruded Cut, and click the End Condition Through All. Before we click OK, let's look at the Feature Scope, an option exclusive to assembly features. It's set to Auto Select, which selects all the components that the preview passes through. In this case, 3 components. We can click OK and all 3 components are cut with a cut extrude feature placed at the bottom of the Feature Manager design tree. It may look like any other cut feature, but here is where it is unique. I'll open the parts affected by the assembly feature and there is no evidence of the cut. This is due to the assembly feature being assembly level only, but that can be changed. Let's return to the assembly. I didn't want the lowest component to be cut, so let's edit the feature. I want to skip a component in the path, so let's clear Auto Select and use Selected Components. After clearing the list, I'll select the first 2 components in the path and click OK. Now let's say we want the cut features to be present in the part components, not just the assembly. I'll edit the assembly feature in the Feature Scope. In the Feature Scope, I'll click Propagate Features to Parts and click OK. Now that we open the individual parts, we'll see that each one has a cut feature with external references to the assembly. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, click the link in the description below to access more great content.